Hi, my name is Jordan Nielson. I'm a biologist out of the Central Region for Division of Wildlife. We're here at Jordanelle today to go gill netting. The reason we come out to gill net is to sample our cold water species like the trout and the yellow perch. In recent years, because of all the predation and competition with some of the other fishes that are in here, our rainbow trout fishery has suffered a little bit, so we're keeping really close tabs on it. What we're going to do today, we have two boats we're going to launch. We have 8 gill nets out in the water. Half of them float up at the surface. Those tend to catch the rainbow trout really well. Half of them dive down to the bottom of the reservoir. They're 6 feet tall and about 80 feet long. Several different mesh sizes so we can catch all the different sizes of fish. We'll go out, we'll pull them up, bring them back to the boat ramp where we'll have a crew of people here ready to string them out and pull all the fish out. We take them, we weigh them, we measure them. Any trout or any other bass, sport fish type species, we'll open them up, we'll look what's in their stomach, make sure that they're eating well, we'll look at their fat content in their guts, and make sure they're just healthy overall. Okay, well, thanks for coming out gill netting with us today. It was great to have you guys along. As you can see, gill netting can be a lot of work. It can be a little bit messy, but it can also be a lot of fun. We see a lot of different sport fish species this way. Again, gill netting is really important to help us monitor our trends across time in our reservoirs and to make sure that we are managing the reservoirs in such a way that anglers can come out here and have a good chance of catching the fish species that they want to catch.